Hey there, in this video we're going to look at how you can quickly beef up an acoustic or an electronic drum sample by adding your own kick or snare or different drum components over the top of the existing sample. Now, I'm going to double click on this event here, and this is just an acoustic drum sample, and on the left hand side in the inspector I get the hit points drop down menu. Now I'm just cycling this so that it cycles from the end point back to the start and just keeps going over and over again. Now over in the hit points, I can define a threshold which is going to put these vertical lines down the bottom in the lower zone over the top of my wave file. So I'm using this threshold slider and I'm moving it to the right and to the left, and I'm using the intensity slider until I'm capturing just the snare hits. Now, if the hit points aren't perfect or the detection's a little bit off, you can go up and select Edit Hit Points. And now I can go through each of these different sections and I can move these hit points up the top if I need to make any edits. I can also delete them. So I'm pretty confident that I've got all of my snare hit points here. So now it's a matter of extracting these hit points and turning them into something that I can use to trigger an external drum sound to blend in with this sample. So to do that, I'm going to go to Create MIDI Notes. There's a few options here in terms of which pitch we want to extract these notes to, the note length, and of course, the destination. So I'm selecting a new MIDI track, but you could also copy it to the project clipboard and then paste it onto another track that you have prepared. As soon as I hit OK, you can see these MIDI notes, which represent my snare drums, and they're just down on a MIDI track. Just above the MIDI track, I've got an instance of Groove Agent SE3 with an acoustic kit loaded in. And these are the sounds that I'm going to use to add to this acoustic drum sample. And you can see that my snare is on D1. So all I'm going to do is drag at this part up. I'm just going to remove my MIDI track, which basically I didn't need. I could have copied and pasted it straight to Groove Agent, but I just wanted to show you how to create a MIDI track. Now, I need to select all of these notes and drag them up to D1 so they're triggering a snare and not a kick drum. So I've selected Control A and I'm just dragging them straight up into the snare slot. And now we've got a snare being triggered over the top of this acoustic groove. If you want to take it a step further, you could create a drum map from the Groove Agent SE3 instrument by clicking on this drop-down menu right here and selecting Create Map from Instrument. And now it's mapped all of those instrument names on the left-hand side to this drum kit that we have loaded in Groove Agent. And you can see that the diamonds on the grid represent the snares. And we could go and add extra parts if we wanted to. Finally, you can go in and mess with these really cool parameters inside of Groove Agent to blend the sound in even further and give it more character. So it might be like dropping the pitch of the snare or adding more room or more overheads or detuning it. It's completely up to you to be as creative as you want to be. Thanks for taking the time to stop by and check out this video. Please give us the thumbs up if you've learned something and subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel for plenty more videos just like this. I'll see you soon.